Meantime, buzz continues around Governor Rick Scott's State of the State speech last night.
In his first state address, Governor Scott laid out big plans for major budget cuts.
Now, those include $700 billion in education. That should be $1 million in education alone. West 2's Amanda Ober continues our coverage from the Capitol in Tallahassee.
Florida Governor Rick Scott kicked off this year's legislative session by telling lawmakers he'll forgo being popular and instead will be a tough CEO who will push for controversial cuts to spending and state programs.
The governor of the great state of Florida.
In his State of the State address, Governor Rick Scott stuck to his ongoing themes, slash state spending and create jobs. He also tasked legislators with being bold.
My jobs budget has plenty of critics. Some critics are accustomed to big government and will fight to protect special interest. Don't let special interests persuade you to turn your backs on the people who elected you.
Scott's proposals to revamp Medicaid, reform state pension plans, and cut education spending are popular with Tea Partiers who rallied outside the Capitol. The governor's plans are not so popular with union supporters and liberals who held a protest just across the street. Even in the Republican-dominated legislature, there's skepticism Scott's cuts can lead to the 700,000 jobs he promises. Senator Thad Altman of Vieira went to court to try and force the governor to accept federal funds for high-speed rail, a project Altman believes would have created 24,000 jobs.
It was a big step backward, and probably he's done more in the first 2 weeks of being governor to set the state of Florida back than any governor that we've had.
House Speaker Dean Cannon of Winter Park struck a more conciliatory tone regarding the governor's plans.
You know, we may have to reduce spending on good programs in order to protect necessary programs. That's what we'll do, which is the same thing that small businesses do or families do when they have budget challenges.
Both the governor and lawmakers will be duking it out for the next 2 months under the watchful eyes of the citizens they serve. Amanda Ober reporting West 2 News.